In the old days, it was the signal to gather, people summoned to the wharf by the sound of the horn. It was the sound of homecoming, of goodbyes. Sons, daughters, goods, possessions, everything came and went on the coastal boat. It was the center of life on this coast, Newfoundland's south coast, where some still listen for the sound of the horn. A coastal boat has been on this run for decades. Before the roads came, it was the only lifeline, and still is for the half a dozen communities that are still totally isolated. But this trip marks a turning point for them and for the rest of the south coast. The era of the coastal boat is ending. I'm Pauline Thornhill, and this is the Tavernor's last run. The Tavernor will steam from here in Bay Largent to Port of Basque and back, and that will be it. The coastal service on the island's south coast will be finished. The provincial government is taking over from Marine Atlantic. It's replacing the Tavernor with several ferries. Each will service a smaller section of the coast. So the isolated places will still have a link to the outside, but that link will no longer be the Tavernor, and the days of traveling the length of the coast on one boat will be over.
15 and 5, thank you very much.
15 and 5, thank you.
On the rent tower, is it? And you're 11,
right? Henry Banfield has punched 36 years with Marine Atlantic. He's retiring, and ironically, his last trip is this one.
There's a different feeling about it, right? And the other time we come here, we know we're coming back again to pick up passion and sail out of here. So next time, needless to say, we sail out of here, that's it, no more, right?
An assortment of passengers came aboard for this trip, some by accident. Take Bob and Brenda Marshall, vacationing from Cornerbrook.
We were planning a trip from Virgil to Ramia. We had a bread and breakfast booked in Ramia. We're going overnight. So when the boat docked in Virgil, we got on the wrong boat.
It was the best mistake we ever made. We've been to Virgil before, but like certainly none. Well, these are just accessible, most of these places, by water. So, I mean, it's probably the only chance we will ever have to get to them. Because now I think the boats that will be replacing this one are only doing small segments. So like this, we get to do quite a major part of the south coast.
For the last time, the Tavernor leaves Bay Largent with her load of passengers. Dusk closes in her wake. It's a 24-hour steam to Port of Basque. The Tavernor will call in a dozen communities along the way, half of them still totally isolated.
The old rain is getting worse, isn't it? 4 to 5 degrees.
4 to 5, sir.
The next morning's rain is no surprise to Captain Keith Stuckless.
Port some more,
sir.
He's seen lots of this on the south coast. He's also seen lots of the Tavernor.
Midships.
He served on her as seaman, as third officer, as first officer, and now as master.
Oh, she's a grand old lady. she's the last of the newer ships are different, and a lot of people tend to have a feeling for older ships. And I guess this is the last of a breed of ships.
The Tavernor truly is the grand old lady of the coast. She's 33 years old, the oldest of Marine Atlantic's fleet of ships. She came on stream in the early 60s, when many outports were still untouched by novelties of the outside world.
like electricity and telephones had just started to reach many of these places. But even these outside influences were nothing compared to the lure of the coastal boat. When the horn blew, people flocked to the wharf. And even today, even in driving rain, the coastal boat still brings people out. This is McCallum, one of the isolated communities about halfway along the South Coast Run, one of the places that's depended on the coastal boat since the beginning.
Right now.
This voyage that we're on now, this trip we're on now, is the last of the Coastal Service on Newfoundland as such. There's still a Coastal Service in Labrador, or will be from Lewisport to St. Anthony and Labrador, but who knows how long it's going to last. So basically, it is the end of the Coastal Service for on the island.
Green is from Francois, the next isolated port of call. Over the years, she's eaten her share of Tavernor food, but this meal will be the last.
I know I'll never have the privilege, the chance to make this trip again. And, well, it's the end of an era, and it's a sad one. And not saying like a boat, future boat coming up is not going to be a good boat. I don't know that, but I know that it won't be as good as this. It can't take this boat's place. No matter what they do with it, or whatever, they'll never take this boat's place. I can't speak for everyone in Francois. No one can do that. But I can speak for a good majority that I won't be the only one that'll be sad to see this boat go.
Well, goodbye, Henry.
Bye, dear.
It's been nice all those years.
Well, we'll see you.
Yeah. Thanks for everything. Okay.
Take care.
Yeah. You too.
Bye.
Bye. Nice meeting you.
Yeah.
When we come back, we'll rejoin the boat in Portobello, where we'll begin the last leg of the Tavernor's last run. In Port-au-Basque, the crew prepares for the Tavernor's trip back down the coast one last time.
Port-au-Basque traffic,
Tavernor.
Tavernor, Port-au-Basque traffic, go ahead, over.
Roger, we're ready to start down this time.
Let's go aft.
the Taverners on her way, steaming toward the end of her South Coast career.
What kind of a reception do you expect to get now when you work your way back down the coast?
I got a feeling the waters will probably be full. You know, I don't know about the weather now. Today it might not cooperate. It's calling for a lot of rain, but barring the weather, I think pretty well everybody will be down to see us getting the last pictures of the Tavernor. This vessel's been a lifeline to all these communities, and the effect of today is all over. That's the bottom line.
Is the first stop after Port of Bass, another one of the isolated places that pepper the South Coast. It's a place acutely aware of its dependence on the coastal boat and the significance of this day. The whole school has turned out for the Tavernor, for the end of a chapter of South Coast history.
Turn around, little assholes.
For Diane Taylor, it's the end of a job. For the past 16 years, she's worked for Marine Atlantic as caretaker of the wharf. But the new ferry service won't be using caretakers. People will be responsible for unloading and sorting their own freight. So this is Diane's last load.
Oh, I can't express the feeling. I don't know, it's pretty hard to express, you know, after working there for 16 years and having for this to be the last day at work and last day for the Tavernor. It's really difficult. I came in on the boat this morning, and when I got on it, I just got on in tears, because knowing that it was going to be the last trip I was going to make on her was really difficult for me to do, you know. And
so is it the fact that you're losing your job?
No, it's, you know, I've met so many people, you know, passengers and crew, they're all tremendous. And, you know, I couldn't ask for a better bunch of people to work with than I have. And especially the crew that's on now, because they're really, really good, you know.
Yeah. Come here.
Don't forget that I still have your Christmas list, isn't it?
That's right, Doc.
See them all out there, right? And it's sort of touching, you know, see them there. And a lot of the people were very emotional, as you see, right? But I don't know. It's hard to take, really.
And do the rest of the crew feel the same way you do?
Oh, yeah. I noticed a lot of them wasn't even on the deck.
Next stop, Grand Brit, the place with the beautiful waterfall.
I don't know.
Grand Britt is the smallest of all the South Coast communities, just 55 people, and like La Poyle, totally isolated. The whole school turned out for the Tavernor here, too, all six students. The whole school and every video camera in the harbor.
Hi, Henry. The whole of people around here, you know, they've been... It's part of their heritage is gone, you know?
They've seen the Tavernor come in and out for so many years, seen their children go away to school, and seen the babies come home on the boats, you know, the ones born in the winter season and that.
We know the crew members just like we know our family. We know them all by name. They know all of us. And they feel the same way as we do. They can't believe they're leaving. They're not coming back anymore. That's the reaction we get from them, you know? So that's why we're all over here with our cameras, so we can do our own show.
One more community bidding the Tavernor final farewell. One more harbor that will never see a coastal boat again.
Do you remember, Grand Britt, from the last time you were here? 70 years ago?
Yeah, I can, yeah.
You see, the waterfall.
Once I saw it, I could...
The waterfall with the church here, when you're going in, it's beautiful. It's almost like a postcard.
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
It's 26 miles up from Grand Britt to Virgia.
Oh, yes, yeah.
Marion Stucklist is Keith's wife. When she last made this trip, she was pregnant with their first child, 17 years ago. When it seemed like coastal boats would be around forever.
I wanted to see the last one, see what the reaction of the people, and see what it was like to saw the reaction of the crew, and sad.
Just out of Port of Bass, you go down for a cup of coffee, and usually there's always someone there to share a joke or whatever, but it seemed like people were, two or three people off in the corner, they'd be talking, you could sense, it's almost like you're in a morgue. It's not like a celebration, it's more like a funeral one is.
Gray River, hidden behind the hills, shrouded in fog, like a place time forgot. But change will come here too, as in all the other South Coast communities.
You don't want to see, the Tavern to leave, right? I don't, for sure. I like keeping on all if I could, right? But you can't, right?
Is it something about that particular boat, though?
Oh, yeah, it means a lot because she's been here so long, see? Like one in the power of the river because she's been here that long, right? We every day see her go.
Don't feel too good about it myself. No, I think she really missed on this coast. No, I don't think service, what we're going to get in the future, is ever going to be like what we served by sea in, right?
The end of the Tavernor means the beginning of the new ferry service. There are some on this coast that see that as a good thing. It should mean a better schedule, a vessel running in and out of their community each and every day. So while some won't miss the old schedule, they will miss the old boat and the crewmen, who many have come to know as friends.
For my part, I've been on the Labrador for the past 7 years or so, and you knew in the fall or the winter you're going to get a trip or two on the South Coast. And once this year comes, there's no more South Coast to fall back on, and you may never see it again. Like the Wharfingers and some of the people I knew around the coast, all you do is just shake hands and say, well, we'll meet you again sometime, but I don't know when.
Thank you. trip also marks the last time this crew will be together.
Thank you, Stuart.
Some will retire. Some will be assigned to other boats. Others don't know what will happen. So they celebrate their last meal together. It's as formal as it gets on the Tavernor. Jig's dinner with all the trimmings. The meal marks the end of a journey. Before long, we're back in Bay Largent. Here, the last of the passengers get off, the last of the cargo is unloaded, and the Tavernor's South Coast career comes to a close. She'll go on to the Labrador run in the fall, but after that, the grand old lady will probably be sold. The official end to one of the longest chapters of South Coast history. Enjoy the Tavernor's last run. Land and Sea won't be seen next week. Instead, the CBC presents the season debut of the current affairs show, Soundings. Land and Sea will be back the week after, though, and here's a peek at what's in store. For the love of goats, it's a new wave of goat farming. More and more people are discovering the joy of goats.
Oh, yes, yes, oh.
Now, give me a kiss. Give me a fight. There.
Come on, you old new goat. There, you ought to lie down, aren't you? Come on.
For the love of goats, 2 weeks from now on Land and Sea.